Welcome back to the show. On the bench, Revell USA's 1962 Chevy Impala SS Hardtop 3-in-1. That is a long title. It's in 1/25th scale. It's got 182 parts because it's a 3-in-1. Let's take a look at everything that's in the cool box when you're going to get it. First up, all three options in there. You can build them or you can build any combination of the two. We got our lowrider option, our more modern mod rod option, we've got our gasser option, and we've got our stock Impala option. So let's start pulling stuff out. This time we'll start on the right side of the desk. We got a beautiful new gigantic decal sheet. Check out all the cool stuff that's on there. Gauges, locks, we've got performance gauges, we've got stock gauges, we've got everything you could think of. Make your painting life easier. I love that they included the side striping with the metallic tone to it. That is just awesome. Got little Revell logos on there, the old ones, that's sweet. Got the sponsors, got the drag decals, got hood pins. All this stuff is handy on any other build as well. Gorgeous new decal sheet in the box. We've got transparent red for the tail lights. We've got windshield, back glass, side lights, and headlights in the clear bag. I'm leaving them in there for now. We've got one set of tires, two set of tires, and a set of back tires. We've got drag slicks for the back on the gasser option. They are smooth wall. They are hollow, which means you can assemble the wheel package and slide those over the top. We've got solid rubber tires, the performance modern tires. Excellent tread design. No name that I can see around the sidewalls. It is a smooth wall tire. You got four of those low pros. And we've got the stock set of tires, the old bias plies. Nice tread pattern on there. One side completely smooth. One side has a slight ribbed texture to it. You could actually trace that for a white wall if you desired. So that's all for the tires. Three entire chrome trees. Custom and stock parts. We've got headers, air cleaners, stock rear bumper. On this one, we've got our custom wheels, custom bumpers, knockoffs for the wheels, custom valve covers, intake. I mean, like I said, 182 parts in a car kit. This has got everything in it. Got some nice hubcaps, trim for the bottom of the doors, interior pieces, dual quads there, shifters, door handles, windshield wiper blades, emblems, grill, hood trim, everything on that. Just an outstanding level of detail on that kit. Now let's switch over to the styrene parts. As you can see, we're going to continue that 3-in-1 theme. We got some wheel backs here, we've got front suspension, springs. Repeated are the stock or low, I'm not sure which one is which right now, but we've got it repeated for the stock gasser or lowrider parts there. We'll get some more here. We got a beautiful interior, back seat, front separated seats with their seat back. Full detail even on the seat back. And they really go all out with this stuff. We got our other front seats, our sport bucket seats. All the detail on there, front and back. We've got our interior pan. We've got our chassis here. Check out the X on that. Locating holes for your different options. Even tiny little pieces there. Absolutely superb mold quality holding up on this thing. We got our interior tub. Should make painting or flocking carpet if you choose to do so. Manual transmission, inner fenders, that'll make for easy painting with the contrasting colors they did on the GM. We've got steelies. We've got our, looks like a drag steelie on the back. We've got our drag parts with our exhaust dumps, roll cage, higher springs. I'm stacking up styrene on the side. Now we've got all of our radiator linings, air cleaner parts, suspension, battery, firewall, all extensive for you. This thing has got so much detail. We've got three more trees alone for that 409, stock valve covers, cylinder heads, belt and pulley system, super thin molding on that belt and pulley with no flash, stock manifolds compared to the exhaust, water pump system. We've got our stock exhaust system here, wheels, springs, air cleaner, stock valve covers for the 409, skinny drive shaft, steering. Look at that exhaust system routes through there. Pretty detailed. We've got our dashboard. Got decals for that. We've got our interior panels, which are superbly detailed. Get the right angle so you can see those. Steering wheel, hood hinges, steering column, hood. It's got underhood detail. Very much a modern styled kit. Here is the body, the giant slab body. Molding is prominent, going to be easy to lay that decal down there. Trim around the fenders, nice door panel lines. All straight and true. Body sits flat, not warped or wandering everywhere. Excellent, little inserts for trim. We are all set. So I'm going to start building mine. That was everything that was in the box. We'll see you in just a second. The fit of all the parts is superb, so it's just a matter of following Revell's really nice line drawings and getting everything put together the correct way, paying attention to the way things go. There is nothing confusing. There's nothing that you need to worry about. Now, I've done sub-assemblies here, as always, so I can get in and start painting things up. We can see how nice that radiator, battery, and shroud assembly goes together. I'll be painting that all one color in the car, underneath the hood, and then we can accent some things with some gloss coats and stuff to draw out the different details. But I like to get a lot of things assembled and do some hand painting later. We've got that firewall attached so I can get this sprayed. I can get the interior carpet sprayed. There'll be different colors, but it's easy enough to mask those off. Leave a little bit on the tree so I have something to grip onto when I paint. We've got some details in here. Stuff that can be picked out with a paintbrush or will match the firewall color. So we've got all that all set up there. I've got the hubcaps cut off separately so I can dull coat those. I don't want chrome hubcaps. I want them a little dulled. The other chrome trees we'll be leaving alone. These are the stock parts chrome trees. So we've got all of our trim, hood molding, dashboard, and all that stuff. We can do black washes in here. We can work with a lot of this stuff on its own trees, and those we will set aside. You're going to have all kinds of extra parts. These are all the hot rod parts left over we didn't touch. Here's all the drag parts you're going to have, roll cages, exhaust dumps, wheels, everything. So that's all going to be on the side as spare parts. I've got my other interior parts cut off, my door panels, my steering column, which I glued together. So I don't have to do that with super glue later. We'll get some paint on that. The stock exhaust system, the wheel backs, the drive shaft, the air cleaner, and the valve covers will all get painted black primer for detail. Then we'll cut things free and spray them with their final colors after we get all that taken care of. I like to super glue the pins in place. You don't really have to, but I super glue them, hit them with some activator, and then I don't ever have to worry about them pushing free or getting lost. The dashboard's on its own little tree. It's not going to be the exact same color as the interior. I wanted a little bit of a darker tone, so I got it on its own tree here on the side. We can get that painted. The hood and the bumper trim panel are going to be the body color, so we can just leave those together. Clip, paint. When I cut off the parts, if I need to touch them up, I just little spritz of paint in a can and then brush it on with a tiny brush, and we're all set to go. The chassis itself is a beautiful piece of work. Look at all the detail in that suspension down there. We've got it all set up. Make sure you use the correct blocks. The instructions will tell you whether you're building gasser, performance, mod rod, or older vehicle, the stock vehicle like I did. We can see our individual springs in there, linkages. We can get paint on all of that by hand. We got our upper A-arms. I do when I pull them off, I number them so that I know which ones they were, so I don't try to stick them on the wrong side, and even a steering column in this thing. So that's all ready to be painted up. and detailed as we go. Belt, pulley system, and fan clutch are all on that tree there. We've got our air conditioning unit, we've got our manifolds and our radiator lines. We can get this all primed, cut them free, metallicize, or separately paint the manifolds. A lot of times I attach the manifolds right away. These ones have very large lugs that will slide into the engine. No need, I can paint them on a tree with spray and push them in. Speaking of that 409, you can see those giant lugs where the exhaust will go. Otherwise, everything else has been glued on so I can detail it. Distributor, coil, oil filler, fuel pump, starter. I like to put all that on there. Excellent detail on that 409 multi-piece engine. The intake will be painted, but what's nice about it is I can paint the valve covers separately, paint the intake by hand so that I can attach all the small parts with model glue. Then what I can do is go in and hand brush that intake, put the valve covers on, and you won't notice when I make any mistakes off to the side with the paint. And it'll give it a little bit of a different tone than the valve covers. The seats I'm using are the plain Jane seats in the front end with the back glued on, and the one-piece back seat. They're on their own tree. I can paint those separately. And the body, of course, needed no work at all. It was extremely clean coming out of the box. So that is it, and I am going to head over to the paint section.
Thank you. Thank you.
With the easy detailing out of the way, everything's going together super slick. I wanted to leave more apart than I usually do because I got to show you the detail in this kit. That is the 409. No decals on it yet, but we'll get to those. Beautiful, beautiful engine. I did it as a pretty new engine, but you can see the carburation, fuel pumps, manifolds, the generator hanging off the side with its own little brackets. so it's not hanging in no man's land. The fan clutch, it is a pretty cool looking assembly. Goes together nice. That'd be beautiful in any kit or as a display on its own on the side. See what that Del Coat does over the chrome? When I brush it on, gives it that metallic look, that kind of an argent look to it, but it looks real sharp. Then we've got the chrome bumper, so they do contrast like it would on the real car on the back. That grille looks sharp with the headlights glued in. That's ready to go on the car. The front bumper and its body colored trim panel are all glued together. There's some nice large tabs. I just super glued them together. Those are set to go. Got our air cleaner. Looks awesome with that little bit of gloss coat on it. Same as the radiator assembly. Got our battery decked out. All set to go on that. That will be attached. Got our chassis ready to go with our exhaust in it. Drive shaft glued in. We just need to place our engine in. Glue that in place. And that's set to be mated with the interior. Nice looking interior. Got the dash decals on, all that chrome trim done in separate parts. Got the door panels done. They don't need much detail, just accent with a silver pen, the door handles and whatnot. Got our little rear speaker or whatever that is back there, and the slightly contrasting color between the upper deck and the seats just stands out just enough. Steering wheel detail, got that floor shifter in there. We are all set to go. Got our firewall ready with all of its detail, and under there with the fender liners, and then the body. Got the mirror glued in, hood put together with its trim panels glued in. That's just resting on its mounts. Did a little black wash on the vents, little black wash on the trim on the back. Used Mod Podge and silver Sharpie to do all the trim work like I've shown in numerous videos. None of this trim on the side needed to be marked in because I have those awesome decals. Got to put our hood trim on. All kinds of final small stuff once the car's all glued together. And I don't have to worry about having to mate the body or anything. So this is going to end up dropping down like so. The engine will be under the hood. Then I will glue in the radiator mount on the front of that once that's all together. Then I will put the body on and attach all the chrome pieces, the trim along the bottom, door handles, mirror I pre-assembled, hood trim, and the windshield wipers. Then finally, those long side decals. You can decide which ones you like, the black or the white, with the silver trim around it. And then numerous hubcap logos, whichever ones you like, different body trim, all that kind of stuff will go on the car. We will be back for the final when I'm done. Another kit in the books, this one Revell's 125th scale 1962 Chevrolet Impala SS Hardtop 3-in-1. I can say that without having to take a breath in the middle of it. It's a really sweet kit. I love the way that Krylon rose gold turned out on there. I was a little worried about the flake at first, but it's great size on the car. It doesn't look too big or anything like it did when I first sprayed it. It all settled down. Two things to talk about on final assembly of that you might want to know about. One, these little fender ornaments were kind of arced the wrong way, and I couldn't straighten them out without breaking them. So they are glued in, but you might want to find a way to smooth those down and get them to sit better along the straight fenders. Two, I wanted to use the black and silver stripe. I thought that would look best on a gold car in the style I wanted to do, that little bit of accent. But when I applied that decal, it shattered on the driver's side. I never even tried the passenger side because the driver's side was so mangled and cracked and broken, and I couldn't get anything to line up anymore. I switched to the white and silver, and it looks beautiful on the car, and it went on without an issue, and none of the other decals had a problem. None of the other ones across the back or anything. So I think it was just bad luck on that one decal or whatever. But I always like to be honest. Dropping the body onto the chassis is extremely easy. Just split it in the middle and shove it straight down. Tuck your fenders in and you are all set to go on this kit. And then I glued all the accoutrement on. I glued the grille and the bumper and the fender ornaments, the door handles, the rear bumper, and the driver's side mirror all go on beautifully without any problems. No problems with fit or finish on it. I brushed on two coats of Future. You guys gotta listen when I talk. Brushed on two coats of Future. Then I go for a walk. You don't touch it. You don't sand it. You don't buff it. You don't wax it. You don't do anything if you want to do it my way. My way is brushing on two coats of Future back to back and then disappearing for 2 to 3 hours. It hardens up and dries beautifully and gives us that nice shine, but not that liquid whale snot poured over it wet look. I like just that kind of factory shine where you can see a reflection in the trunk lid, but it's not that intense, super moist shine. I love the kit, super easy to work on, got our tail lights sticking out and all that. Love that. And then I showed you how to dull coat that upper panel to get that chrome-ish metal look that they had to them. Showed you how to detail the hubcaps, and that gorgeous 409 that I had to show you separately is parked under the hood of this bad boy. I would happily build this kit again, so in a couple years if they reissue it, we'll do a gasser with it, we'll do a modern car with the bigger wheels, I don't know. But I wanted to build this one bone stock for my personal collection. So easy to go together. We thank Revell USA for sending this over. When you get yours, build it your way. Have fun doing it, and don't worry about what anybody else thinks, because it's all done for you. It's your model. I'll link down in the description. ModelRoundup.com has these in stock and ready to ship. Once again, thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.